Hi everybody, welcome to another how-to video with Kodaster and Salome Mecca. And today I want to talk about nonlinear time history static analysis, applying a displacement control analysis in a simple rod that you see here, a simple cylinder, where we're going also to use material nonlinearity with azotropic hardening or kinematic hardening, and also going to have to impose large strains, large deformations, and we're going to use the logarithmic nonlinear model, which is related to the true strains and the true stresses, or Encke strain if you ever heard about it. It's an imaginary example, but I think it is very nice to see these results. As always, you will be able to download everything from our repository in GitHub, JesusBuild Kodaster examples, and an example that will be called the rod. And I'm going to go through the command file Python code, so I'm not going to use Kodaster study. And you will be able then to recreate everything. Just to show that here a quick video. This is the analysis that I want to do. This is a cyclic analysis. And also I'm going to do a monotonic analysis in the two directions. So the first thing that I want to show is how to create this cylinder. There is a primitive button in the geometry module. And I did everything in Newton and millimeters. So I had the 10 millimeters radius, 100 height, and then you see here you can have the pattern if you want divided square or hexagon. I'm going to use square. Of course, then I created some groups. I'm not going to show this. You should be able to do that, or if otherwise you can see the other tutorials that we have. Just want to show how I did the mesh, because I was able to get a nice structured mesh. So this was a cylinder, create mesh, and here I'm going to select a extrusion 3D, and I see that then I just go in the one dimension and I select wire discretization with a local length hypothesis. Local length, and this local length I selected equal to 2 millimeters. So if I do that, I can create, compute this mesh, and I see that I have hexahedrons only and quadrangles. So this is a very nice structured mesh for my analysis. I can of course go and reduce this number of the local length if I want fitter mesh, and so on. Okay, so, and this, as you know, then we can import the groups and so on, and then we export it, the med file, and this is already done. So we can go directly now to see how we can construct the command file for this analysis. Okay, so let's go to see one by one the commands. First of all, I have one variable that is the maximum number of iterations that I want to allow, and this I'm going to select equal to 25. Default is 8, and you can always select if you want less iterations and cut the time step, but this also depends on your preferences. Okay, then we have the initial command, and we read the med file, and we assign the model. Everything is a 3D model, as you saw, so there is no specific other specific options. So for every all the model is a 3D model, and here we go and we create the material. So it is a material that is based on steel, but as you will see, it has also some imaginary values. So I'm using 200,000 megapascal as the modulus of elasticity, and 0.2 as the Poisson ratio. And in order to account for material nonlinearity, here is the first step where I have to assign a material, not to assign, to define what type of material nonlinearity I want. It is important to note that here I can have more instances of a material nonlinearity. So let's say this material can have more models, and then I can select which one I want when I will do the analysis, as we will see. The document that I have to follow here is the document U4.51.11, Nonlinear Behaviors, and this is in English. Usually what I do, if you go from the forum, you can always have both versions, but usually I want to make sure that I have the default version or the version 14, for example. And I can have here, right, instead of EN for English, FR for French. And this is the French version, and I always suggest to have both, because if you want to see the specific keywords, sometimes it's better to be sure that you're using the correct keyword. Make reference to the French version. In any case, these are all a list of all the nonlinear models that there are in Kodastere, and there are a lot of them. And this is a very, very long list of the material models. So, and of course, then there is also in front, that is a separate module where you can actually code your own material law. And then we will see also the deformation for the cases for the nonlinear geometric nonlinearity. What are the options here? So this is a very important document. And let's see here for elastoplastic model with isotropic or kinematic hardening. We're going to use von Mises criterion with kinematic hardening. So here you can see that, as it says here, you have to use the Phi material and use acroline is the keyword, and elast for the elastic properties. Then you have, you know, in what kind of elements you can use it, 3D, 2D, and so on. And then what are the internal variables that you can have. There are six components of the kinematic tensor, a seventh component, indicator of plasticity, and so on. And these are all references of how you can use this material. Let's go also to see the isotropic hardening. So this is the kinematic hardening, and this is the isotropic. They are similar also in the way that you can define them. So both of them, they use acroline in the Defi material. Then you select which one you want in the operator of the nonlinear analysis. And of course, okay, so you would have to go in this document then to see what are the values that you have to fill in for this, but I'm going to show you. So we have this material, acroline we have to use, and we have to input two parameters. One is the yield stress. And the yield stress should be something like 500 for steel. I'm going to use a much bigger value, that is 20,000. And the reason I'm doing this is because I want to do an analysis with large strains and large deformations. So in order to achieve this, I am using this imaginary material that will yield very high, very large deformation. It's like 20% or something, 10%. In any case, this would be 500 if it was a real steel. And this is the plastic modulus. So in this case, it is 100 times less than the elastic modulus. Okay, once we have defined the material, we have to assign it. So a FEM material, as you know, and everywhere in all the model, we assign the material that we created before. Then we have to define the time steps that we want to do the analysis. And this is the defillist real is the important command that we need absolutely. So in this case, we are saying that we want to start from zero and we want to do an analysis of 4 seconds with 40 time steps. So we will have a time step of 0.1 second. And this will be our analysis of 40 steps. Then we can use this defillist inst with a method, is automatic in this case, and we make reference to the list that we created before. And this is used if we want to have the feature that we cut the time step if we don't hit the convergence criteria. So if you don't do this and you have only what is required, if there is no convergence and you exceed the number of iterations that is by default is 8, then the program will stop and will exit with an error and you will not get any results back. If you do like this and you select defillist inst with the method, then the program will, if there is no convergence, will divide by 2 the time step, will try to seek convergence with a reduced time step, and will keep reducing the time step until it is a very, very small value. So this is usually recommended to do. And okay, so this is regarding the analysis. Then we are using the fif function to define the function of the load. So this is, imagine it like a ramp function if it's a monotonic analysis, or a cyclic function. In this case, I'm using, I have two cases, let's say. Because I want to reproduce both or a cyclic load or a monotonic load. These are all the cases that I did for this example, and you can also recreate them. And for the cyclic, you will use this one. For the monotonic, you will use the other. So what we're doing here, we're doing that we're creating a function that is a time parameter. The x is time, and then with Vale we are just giving him x, y values. So we're saying that it starts from 0 with a value of 0, at 1 with a value of 1, at 3 with a value of minus 1, and 4 with a value of 0. So he's doing actually a cyclic analysis in 4 seconds, as we defined here. Or otherwise, we have just a ramp function that starts from 0 and goes to 4. Okay, so let's say that we're going to use this, and this is just a general function. Now we're going to assign the boundary conditions. So at the bottom, we are using, we say that all the displacements are 0 in all directions. At the top, we have all the horizontal displacements equal to 0, and the horizontal the vertical displacement, we give him give a value. It could be 20 or minus 20, depends. Let's say that we use 20. So 20 is 20 millimeters. Remember that the length is 100 millimeters, so we're talking about large displacements and large strains above all, large deformations. Now, this is the load as if it was a single load, so a single displacement. But of course, we have to use it together with the function that we defined here. So let's see how we can do that. We are in stat nonlinear, that is the nonlinear static analysis, the operator. And if we look, okay, we have to give him the material assignment in this case. Since we are using, we have a 3D model, we don't have any vector LM, any element assignment. This is only for beam and cells. So we have the material, we have the behavior that we're going to talk about it in a while, and here we have the loads. So the loads, we have the boundary condition at the bottom and the top, and then the load that we assigned here, that is the displacement we are applying. We are using also the function that we applied here. So you see that by using this together, we can have this effect of applying a function on the load. So at each time step, we have the multiplication of the load, that is 20 millimeters times the value of this function. This is one of the two possibilities to have a variable load. Otherwise, if we don't want to use this, we would have something like vector mecha f, that is a function. So in that case, we would go and we would assign directly a function of time for this load. This is another possibility. So let's go here to see a little bit about comportement, that is the behavior. So in the behavior, we have the deformation, the relation, and then the assignment of the model. In this case, we use tutui. Otherwise, in another case, of course, we are going to use group ma and have the group that we want to assign. Keep in mind that this can be, of course, replicated. So this means that you can assign to different groups of a bigger model what material nonlinearity and what geometric nonlinearity you want to consider. In this case, we just have one material, one body, let's say, that we want to control. And what we need to do here is to put the relation. So what is the material nonlinearity that we're going to use? In this case, it is or misses kinematic hardening, or it could be one misses isotropic hardening. For example, if we see here one misses iso line and so on. So here we would input, let's say, for each case, the correct keyword. So we have always the keyword that goes to defi material and the keyword that goes to comportement. It's not always the same. Sometimes it is the same, but always. So here we have the one misses in a line, the material, we have the echo line. And of course, in the deformation, we also have to tell him what kind of geometric nonlinearity we want to consider. Let's go back to the document. We'll go in the French version that has the correct names. And we can see here that there are five possibilities. We have small displacements, essentially linear analysis. We can have large displacements and large rotations, which is also the usual material geometric nonlinearity that we can consider. But in this case, it will not be possible to use it because you have large deformations. So Podastel will tell you that with large deformations, this is not a good, let's say, choice. And then we have a petite react, that is Something in the middle, I mean, it has some hypotheses that you can see here. Of course, all of this is, you have to study and to try to see what is good, what is not good. So there are some conditions to use the Petit React. Usually, sometimes it has problems of convergence. And then we have simomiche and gdef log. So this is the logarithmic, I said, model for large deformations. And this is similar and is the precedented implementation for large deformations. So this was, this has been implemented a long time ago, and then this was implemented later. So, but I mean, they can be usual in the results, but I think this has a better convergence for large deformations. In any case, what I want to show here, I'm going to do five cases. I'm going to explain in a while. Let's see a little bit the, let's finish here. So we have the comportement, that is the behavior. Then we have the convergence keyword. In the convergence, we apply the maximum number of iterations. If we want to, change it, we don't want to use the default number. And the increment, that is the list that we defined before. So as we said, it can be the defi list real or the defi list inst. We want also the possibility to cut the time steps. The Newton keyword, that you can read about it in this, if you look about stat nonlin and Codaster. I'm not going to go now in detail. And the last thing for stat nonlinear, I want to talk about archivades. So this is essentially what you want to archive, at which time steps you want to archive your results. If you don't use it, so if you don't use it, if there is the possibility that will reduce the time step sometimes and create more time steps, it's the Codaster is going to write all the time steps in your result file. Instead, if you use archivades, you can tell him in which time steps you want to get the results. Usually, for example, let's say that you're doing a dynamic analysis and you are doing an analysis with a time step of 0.001 second, but you want the output only in 0.01 second, say. So every time, every 10 steps, you want the result. And you don't care if convergence reasons is going to do more time steps, say cutting the step in order to reach the solution. You always want to have fixed output, a fixed number of output results. So this is what you need to select. In this case, I'm just using the same list that I created initially. For example, if I didn't want to have 40, but I wanted to have 20 values, I could recreate this. I could say that this I want 20 times, and then I could just use it here like this. It's also used if you want to exclude some values from the fields that it creates automatically, especially for the, again, for the dynamic analysis. Anyway, we just use it like this here, and let's see the final commands. We have a calc champ, so, and we reuse the same name, so it means that we want to enrich our field, and we enrich this field with stresses. It's a Noeo field, which means that is the average stress on each node. the average from all the elements. We have the reaction, and then we have the internal variables. So the internal variables vary and no. By default, we have the internal variables in the Gauss points. So this field vari Elga is computed and is given by default. If we want to calculate at the nodes, not at the Gauss points, then we can specify this. And we could also specify the vari Noeu field, but I think it is not very correct to do an average value of the internal variables. So it is better to use vari Elno, but you can also try with vari Noeu. And you should know that the Elno fields, you cannot visualize them directly in ParaView. You have to use a filter. The same also for Elga fields. And we will see how we can do that. And then we have a post relief T to extract the reaction at the base. So I'm extracting the total reaction in terms of force in the three directions plus moment of, a moment of this force resultant, the total moment, let's say, with respect also to a given point. Now these moments are zero in this case, but I'm just going to leave it like this because one of the future examples will be with a lateral load, and then we will want to have also the moment at the base and do some considerations for the equilibrium. And the operation is extraction. So with this we are creating a table with the total reaction. And we are printing this table in Unité 10. So we are printing this table for each analysis. And we are also printing an RMID file with the results to viewing to visualize in ParaView. And we will tell Codaster to export the displacements, the stresses, and the internal variables. So this is the command file that you will be able to download if you want. They also import in the study if you want to see it better there. And I have done some cases here. So we have three cyclic analyses. The first two are with geometric nonlinearity in terms of logarithmic strain. The first one is a linear material, non-material nonlinearity. The second is with the kinematic hardening. And then I'm doing also the kinematic hardening with small strains, small displacements, linear analysis essentially to see what is the difference. And then I also did two monotonic analyses, one in compression and one in tension with the logarithmic strain. And we're going to see also this in terms of displacement and force. Second. Okay, so with this, just go here. So in order to apply all these different monotonic and cyclic, for example, it has to do with a function. The material has to do with the relation that we use, or it can be ELAS, an elastic material. And the deformation it can be this, the GDEF log, or it can be the petit for analysis and so on. This is how you can recreate all this analysis. And let's go now to see some results. So we go to ParaView and Okay, so I have here the this one is the linear, no, sorry. Case 11 is the monotonic analysis in compression. Yeah, before I show this, I just want to show you something else that is very nice. How we can, I want to show you how we can see the results of the output, the text files that we exported, the actions. And for this, I'm going to use a Jupyter Lab. I don't know if you have ever used it, but I strongly recommend it. You can deep install it. And together with pandas, you can do some very powerful and very quick visualizations. And this, I'm going also to provide this Python document. So I am importing pandas and matplotlib for some plotting and NumPy. And with Shift Enter, and go to the next one, and here just going to want to read all the results. So for each analysis, essentially this is what I am exporting. These are the reactions, and I only need the result Z reaction, so the reaction in the Z direction, because all the others are close to zero. I am mostly interested about this value. And for the first three, so for all the cyclic analysis, I am reading this result file. I'm saying that the header is equal to 4, so it has to neglect the first 4 lines. And then from the others, it will automatically consider the columns. And in order to do that, you have to use this delimiter and the IDEX column false. Of course, it could be easier, but for this is going to work, so it's fine. Otherwise, when you do input table, you always can use a separator keyword, and I think it's something like. There, something like this, and you can specify, for example, to use a comma, so you create like a CSV file. But this would be easier, so at the delimiter would be just a comma. But like this, it should be fine. So what we're doing here, we are reading these three result files. Then I just want to plot. So I am creating a data file with the displacements, because the displacements are not exported. So I am creating the cyclic displacements as I input it in the file. So it's going from 0 to 20 and minus 20 and then back to 0. And this is the result. And then I'm going to create some new fields, some new columns in this new result. So this will be the linear analysis, the linear material model with the logarithmic nonlinearity. And this is what will be the result Z that I get, the reaction minus the reaction. Minus the reaction, because I want to get the force, and I divide by 1000 to get kilonewtons, some kilonewton millimeters. I do this for all the three cases, and then I can go and plot these three. I tell him that the displacements is called is this column. You can see here that you can see the force displacement result. So what do you see here? If we select the linear material model, we can see that the logarithmic strain means that you for tension you have kind of softening, and for the compression you have a hardening effect. And see here that we are talking about 20 millimeters out of 100, so very large deformations. I also calculated the linear stiffness for this case, so I can tell him 1 and 4. And you can see here the this would be the linear case. And we can verify it, because if we multiply, if we show 3 and 4, you can see exactly that with the linear analysis we have essentially an elastoplastic model. Whereas if we introduce the geometric nonlinearity, so if we use 1 and 2, we have something like this, and essentially this is the difference between the geometric nonlinearity with or without. So you see here that we have a softening, and this softening is because also because we are, when we have tension, the area is reduced. So when we are reducing the area of the cylinder due to Poisson effect, even if the stress cannot decrease, on have an elastoplastic model, essentially the total force is decreasing, and the same thing is that the compression, the total force is increasing. And this we can see it if we go and we analyze the other two cases, the monotonic cases, plus and minus. So we do exactly the same calculations. Here we have we go very, very long at 80 millimeters, so like very, very large deformations, and we have compression and tension, and we take exactly this, so we can see that we have the yielding more or less at the same point, but then in tension we have a softening, and in compression hardening. So these are the results that we obtain, and we can now go to ParaView. The have here, for example, I want to show you the deformed shape when we are applying a compression. Make sure, okay. We can see here that kind of like the material is swelling, and you get this effect. Here we see the internal variables. We can also see, okay, the displacements, of course. We have the stresses, and so on. In order to see the, I just want to show. Delete. So this would be the file that we can import, and we see that we have the Ernaux field that we cannot directly visualize it. So in order to visualize this var Ernaux, we have to go to filters, alphabetical, Ernaux field to surface. If we have a Gauss point Elgar field, then we select Elgar field to surface, select Ernaux field to surface, and apply. And this gives us the possibility to visualize these fields. So you see here that we have 6, 7, and then 13 internal variables where you can read the documentation and see, but this is what has to do with the plastic plastic indicator for the material. Let's see also the tension side. Mean scale factor of 1. Okay, so here the result is not not very correct because it depends on the discretization. So let's say that the displacements, you can see that there are some two points where nonlinearity is starting, is concentrated, and then once you have these points, actually all the plasticity is going to be concentrated there. So essentially it is not an analysis that we should take into account, because then if we have a different mesh, we will get different results. But we should know that when we have softening, you should use some other techniques. So the finite element analysis with this framework doesn't work very good. You have to have some gradient measures, some non-local measures. But I just wanted to show what you get. So this is all for today. As I said, you can download from our GitHub repository the files. You can download the Jupyter Lab file. That thing is a very nice way to see some results very quickly. And see you next time with another example.